The Kardashev Scale is one of the most popularized way to determine a civilization's ranking and advancements in whatever universe they reside. Nikolai Kardashev introduced his scale first in 1964. However, this scale has been modified and tweaked by many different cosmologists, astrophysicists, and even science fiction authors over many years. Some of the more popular alternative approaches to the Kardashev scale include Microdimensional Mastery by John Barrow, Planetary Mastery by Robert Zubrin, and Information Mastery by Carl Sagan. Today, our focus will be on the Information Mastery version of the Kardashev scale. But as always, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more content ahead. In his book, The Cosmic Connection, Carl Sagan proposed an alternative approach to the Kardashev scale. He added another dimension to the original scale in addition to the pure energy usage that was first used to characterize different civilizations. Sagan believed that the amount of information available to a civilization should be an important criterion when trying to come up with a useful metric to measure different types of civilizations. So he assigned a lettered scale from A to Z, where each letter meant an order of magnitude increase in the volume of information a civilization can hold. This information, he proposed, could be described in terms of bits, the number of yes or no statements concerning different civilizations and the universe that such civilizations occupy. He started with a type A civilization that he believed would have access to about 10 to the power of 6 bits of unique information available to it. According to Carl Sagan, this civilization type would be extremely primitive and less than any recorded civilization in human history. On the other end of the scale though, a type Z civilization, he argued, would have about 10 to the 31 unique bits of information available, making it the most highly advanced civilization in its universe. But one thing to be aware of here is that for a civilization to advance to higher stages on the scale, it must add unique bits of information to its pre-existing knowledge. For example, information is counted if a brand new technology is invented or an already existing technology is innovated. Moreover, it is important to keep in mind that the information and energy axes are not strictly interdependent here. This means that even a type Z civilization would not need to be a type 3 civilization on the original Kardashev scale. So it could be more or less advanced than a type 3 because the focus of the information mastery scale is on the amount of unique information a civilization possesses. So in general, Carl Sagan believed that a civilization that is high on the energy scale could also be high on the information scale. But this does not necessarily have to be true. The reason for this is because Sagan argued that we certainly can imagine societies that are very complex and require many more bits to characterize them than our society requires, but that are not interested in interstellar communication. This means a highly advanced civilization with numerous bits of information wouldn't necessarily want to expand outwards in its universe, classifying it lower in terms of the original energy usage criterion of the original Kardashev scale. An example of this might be a highly developed civilization like the Autobots or the Decepticons from Transformers, who reside on Cybertron, a highly advanced planet, but do not venture out into space to colonize any other planets or star systems. This is the key difference between Nikolai Kardashev's original idea and Carl Sagan's version of it. Now, this is a game changer since it takes the scale in its own unique direction with its own unique categorization for different types of civilizations. In other words, Sagan tries to provide a more detailed breakdown of the original idea using his own interpretation of what should be required to measure and rank different civilizations within their universes. So let's take a brief look at what Carl Sagan proposed in terms of his information mastery version of the Kardashev scale. to understand the different civilization types on the information mastery scale in terms of the available information content, we must first analyze the concept of a popular game called 20 Questions. In this game, one player, or the answerer, imagines an object or concept and makes an initial classification of it in their mind without revealing the information to the others or the questioners. Now, to identify the correct object or concept, the other players must ask a total of 20 questions, which can be answered only with yes or no statements. So naturally then, we must consider how much information a civilization would need to be able to play such a game. Starting with the very first question of whether we are dealing with an object or a concept already divides the universe into two, perhaps unequal pieces. The second question further divides it into four pieces, and by the same logic, the third question divides it into eight pieces and so on. Now, proceeding in this manner, with all of the 20 questions would then divide the universe into 2 to the power of 20 such unequal pieces, since each question has 2 possible outcomes. Now, let's simplify things here as Carl Sagan originally did in his book, The Cosmic Connection. We know that 2 to the 20 is equal to 2 to the power of 10 all raised to the power of 2. But 2 to the power of 10 is equal to 1024. So to make calculations much faster, Sagan proposed that we approximate 2 to the power of 10, which is 1024, by 1000, which can be represented as 10 to the power of 3. The reason we would want to make this simplification is because it is very easy to work with powers of 10. Now, if we go back to our initial game of 20 questions, we have 2 to the 20, which is equal to 2 to the 10, all raised to the power of 2, but 2 to the 10 can be approximated by 10 to the power of 3, as we said earlier, so we would have 10 to the power of 3, all raised to the power of 2, which would give us 10 to the power of 6. This tells us that to be able to play a game of 20 questions, a civilization must have at least 10 to the power of 6 unique bits of information available to it. So according to Carl Sagan then, a civilization with 10 to the 6 unique bits of information would classify as a type A civilization. This is where the information mastery scale begins in terms of unique bits possessed by different civilizations. As mentioned before, a type A civilization would be extremely primitive and limited in its knowledge. It would be more primitive than any human society we have on record and a good starting point for the information mastery scale. This type of civilization would only have about 10 to the 6 unique bits of information available to it. Perhaps it would include early hominin and hominid societies with very limited information available to them. Now, moving further along the information mastery scale would require much of educated guesswork, since Carl Sagan himself only briefly talks about a few different levels and their capabilities. For example, Greek civilization would be characterized as a type C civilization due to the information they acquired. It is estimated that the earlier Greek civilization contributed about 10 to the 8 unique bits of information. But the total written contribution to our civilization up until the 1970s from the classical Greek civilization is estimated by Philip Morrison to be about 10 to the 9 unique bits of information. This classifies this and other similar civilizations as type D. But perhaps the total amount of information that Periclean Athens contributed would probably make it a type E civilization. This would classify it as having around 10 to the power of 10 unique bits of information, since it added a lot more literature, philosophy, drama, and arts compared to the previous era. Now, going by these standards, Sagan estimated about 10 to the 14 unique bits of information for our civilization of the 1970s. So, in the 70s, we were classified as a type H civilization on the information mastery scale. Currently, it is estimated that we may be a type R civilization on the scale, possessing a total of about 10 to the 23 bits of information. we seem to have moved quite rapidly down the scale from the 70s due to the exponential increase in our computer technologies and computing power. However, some disagree. For example, the fact that it is difficult to determine how much of the available data is unique in our civilization today sparks much of the debate. People do not agree on what should and should not count as data. For instance, if a picture is shared a million times on the internet, does each share count as a unique data, or does only the original copy count? The same could apply to written materials and videos being duplicated and distributed. Either way, the word unique used by Carl Sagan could possibly imply that perhaps only the original work should count. If this is the case, then it would put us a lot lower on the information mastery scale than a type R. But again, that remains an open question due to the ambiguity of the initial classification of the information mastery scale by Carl Sagan. But moving on, Sagan defined a few more levels ahead of the type H civilization of the 70s. He believed that a civilization that has had its first contact with other alien civilizations would probably be somewhere around a type J or a type K. This would put them at about 10 to the power of 15 and 10 to the power of 16 unique bits of information, respectively. Furthermore, a galactic civilization of a million worlds, each with about 1,000 times the information content of the 1970s Earth, would be classified as a type Q civilization in Sagan's view. This civilization would have around 10 to the power of 22 unique bits of information available to it. Now, if we expand this galactic civilization into billions of such galaxies, we would have a type Z civilization with the information content of about 10 to the power of 31 unique bits of information. But a type Z civilization may not be possible according to Sagan, since there wouldn't be enough time in any universe for communication over such vast distances. But that assumption is based on our current, perhaps primitive, method of communication using electromagnetic waves. So for now, we can only speculate on this topic. Now, the civilization types that Carl Sagan did not initially define could be interpolated or extrapolated using his original assumptions of the information mastery scale. But that will be a topic for another time. If you enjoy videos like this, do leave a like, share with your friends and family, and subscribe to our channel. Also, let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.